for getting that work done. It is like that G. H dash is an estimate. That is, we guess that this will be the amount we have to spend. Something like that. Or this much effort we have to put. So that is your H dash. H dash has a good role to play. Because it is not exact. It can be smaller or bigger than what we assume. So if there are more than one path for a branch, suppose you have a tree like this, and the same tree may have something like this again, let's see now. So this path can be reached either by this way, or by this way, or by this way. So there are paths in the same place in different forms. This is the ultimate goal point. You want to know the amount to be spent to say it is three different paths to reach this city. This is a city from where you have to go to Coimbatore, Chennai to Coimbatore. There are some places to which you reach easily. So three different routes. Which is cheaper means, if you know for each part what is the expenditure that you are going to incur, you can select the total cost which is smaller. That alone we will choose. We are not measuring the distance here. Because we are interested in the cost. What is the cost of reaching through this route, through this route, through this route? Whichever is smaller, that route is the best route for us. So this is why we talk like this, it is easily understood. But once you cross this and go to some other place, again, you can go back somewhere here like that. Because there is only one route like this, so it is cutting here. It is not seen there. Then, after this, you know the best. You come to this. Maybe there is a route here. This may be smallest. So you have to compare all paths to a particular place. From the starting point to the end point, you have to calculate through all paths what is the cost. For that, what is the procedure? That is all. A star algorithm sees the first value is there, and the heuristic value alone is to be determined. Once having determined this, then we have to check what is the nearest node here, whether there is any other path. Suppose this is not there, then there is only a because you remove all this. There are only two routes. There are only two routes to see this.
This,
finally you arrive at this, you should know the cost of arriving here. So you have to mark it in the opposite direction. How much time or money you will spend, you have to mark it. So every time when you go there, you will measure. If you choose that, then you will record the values. Otherwise, you can ignore it. That is what A star algorithm. That is the best way of telling. There are programs for that, but you should understand the procedure. What is done? Compute G successor means G value, that is the exact value. Therefore, it can be computed any time. But from what? From best node. You come to this, this is the best node. There is no other node here which takes you to this place. There may be a number of nodes. From there is no direct connectivity to CBE. So these routes are not, these are avoided. Only that one route is available, means then that value is recorded, and that is called G, and that is a fixed value. That is a fixed value. Then H dash we have to calculate. From where H dash comes? First, getting to the best node means we have got to this node. Out of these two, this was best. So we came to this. Then out of these two, this was best. Therefore we came to this. So this is best node. This is your G. So add these two, you will get the this node. So that is how the algorithm goes. So if you write it, you may not like it. Explanation is better. So there is a place, you want to go to different places, which place you want to go, first fix, then see all other routes, all routes. The first one you do is anything, but mark it, what is the value to reach that place, how much you spend, through what route, what city, what towns. Then if you are not happy, you go through other routes also. Then check which is the best, which is, then you find that there is no other route. Therefore, out of four routes available, this is the best route. So you mark that amount or distance, whatever it is, whichever matters. Then from there, where you want to go. Like that you can continue or traverse through an entire graph. The graph may be very big. Hundreds of branches may be there. But from starting point, you go to the best path, best route, best place. Then you try to go to the next level. Like that, there may be 6 levels, 10 levels. So it's a simple algorithm. But you have to understand what is backtracking. This is tracking. Sometimes you have to backtrack. If this is becoming bad enough later on, then you may hope to go this way and go from here somewhere in this. You may have a place here. You want to reach this place. In this case, this best for CBE is not best for this. So we will cut this. We will take this as best path for this. If the destination is this, this may be better than this route. From the figure we can see that it is longer, this is shorter, therefore this is the better. Like that you have some value for that, covering the distance. From that you can say better. Now what has marked here like this initially? How we arrange it? That is, this was the parent. Now this is the parent. So we mark like this. This is the parent, this is the parent, again. No worries. I can stop abruptly anytime. If you are not interested, we stop here. Anyhow, thank you for your patient hearing. At least 1 hour or 1 hour 15 minutes. Thank you. Our lunch time has come, I think.